you can get training, whether it is group entrepreneurship scheme. The Barbados Investment and Development Corporation has a unit which addresses issues of small business development. There's the Enterprise Growth Fund, which has an equity capital facilities, whether it's agriculture, tourism, manufacturing, and I can go through all this. You have the micro enterprise fund access if you're more micro or small business. Fast tracking. I think one of the key things to appreciate is that in the context of our business, because that's what you asked about, there are a number of agencies. But the reality is, and I was facing that only today as we were preparing for a mission to Brazil. Unfortunately, in the context of Barbados, a lot of entrepreneurs, not entrepreneurs, a lot of would-be business people, because I'm very clear as to how I define entrepreneurship, a lot of would-be startup businesses look to others to do everything. I am not suggesting that all of our institutions are streamlined, and I can tell you that efforts were done to do that. There are a number of mixed funds all over the place in small amounts, and these were amalgamated, etc. But what I can tell you from my involvement at the level of training, at the level of working with startups, at the level of starting businesses myself, there are a number of institutions there to support you, but the critical point I think was made by Mrs. Cole Hamilton, that if you want to fast track, you have to believe in what you're doing, you have to be prepared to put in the time and effort to do it. And I think a lot of people say we need this, we need that. But when it comes down to asking if they really understand what they need, a lot of them really have not worked it through, or they are prepared to surrender to others to do a number of things that they have to do. I don't know if I answered the question the way you wanted me to answer it, but what I can tell you in summary is that there are a number of institutions, there may be some need for streamlining, and I know that some of that is taking place, but there are institutions and Let me give you an example. I'm sorry you asked because I'm going to take up my comprehensive thing. I made reference to the Economic Partnership Agreement and the Implementation Unit of the Ministry. I read newspapers, I listen to the radio very meticulously, and I've heard of a number of invitations to participate in initiatives multiple. I know that we put together a number of booklets, and these have been promoted, which speak to how you access the European market. If you're in services, if you're in trading in goods, if you're in tourism, if you're in, there were six in the series. But if I ask a lot of entrepreneurs, and they've gone through the Barbados Coalition of Service Industry, the Small Business Association, would have been invited to participate in events and so on, Barbados Manufacturers Association, the various bodies which speak to supporting business people will have gone through. But if you ask a lot of people in doing the research to get you, how much research have you done? Have you utilized these things? They will tell you, I don't know about it. But in fact, there have been a range of media used to promote these things. So I can tell you that to fast track it, the persons themselves need to be willing to fast track. In a lot of instances, I think a lot of would-be business people are existing business. And you refer to people who might have received grants from Caribbean Export from the time it began. A lot of them do not believe in themselves, and they are afraid to take some of the risk, and a lot of them are not prepared to put into what they're doing enough of themselves. A lot of the companies that succeed are those who are hungry enough to succeed, and those who want to do. We can pour as much money and as much energy and as much into you as we want, unless the entrepreneurs themselves. And we have found, our experience has been that those who are hungry, those who have the vision, there is no stopping them. We talk about daily Byron, we talk about Snacks. I mean, he has gone phenomenal far because all we do is we facilitate. You meet and you do what's necessary because we're a world class. We get a lot of complaints about what we're not doing. We have people who've gotten 4 grants and they're still really working on preserving. essentially, the Caribbean is very different. One, because we're so much smaller. We're micro. You know, when people talk about small and medium-sized enterprises, I don't know what they're talking about. It does not really apply to the Caribbean. We are micro companies for the most part. If you're talking about what, you know, Joe Mandelon spoke about, he's one of the largest firms in the Caribbean. And by world standards, it's considered small and medium-sized. So if his is one of the largest firms, then we begin to look at the minuscule size of the firms in our region. The other issue is that because of that, we therefore have to begin to tailor. And one of the great, for me, experiences of this exercise was beginning to understand the unique characteristics of small Caribbean firms, as opposed to what we study in economic textbooks, you know, abroad. Nobody talks about the realities of small firms in a small region. And I think what makes this different is all being able to tailor not just our expectations, but how we pitch in the context of a very small economy. In addition to which, the four judges in London had never themselves had exposure to the reality of small but micro firms like those coming out of the Caribbean. And they were extremely impressed with the ideas, with the innovation, with the creativity, and with the professionalism on the pitch. And I think that is the kind of thing that we're trying to develop, you know, across the world. So that's what makes the platform really will be able to speak to investors and learn about the alternative sources of financing for the businesses and what investors are looking for as investment propositions. We realize that there's very little funding being offered to new and innovative ideas from conventional financing. And as a result, we see Breakpoint as an ecosystem to take new and innovative ideas from concept to money. I've always said that were it left to the Caribbean, that is Google, Facebook, and the internet would be the creation of a kind of angel investor bank. And trying to develop on that side the kind of joint venture capitalists, the angel investors, the venture capitalists, and even crowdfunding to see how we can begin to work on that side of getting investors into the region in non-traditional.